Daniel from Twin Bytes with another tutorial for you. This time I'm going to show you how to update your QuickBooks software on your computer. If you're on a subscription, you're going to get an email every year that tells you to update it. And you download the file and it'll be named something like this where it's got the year on there. And we would simply just run that file. And then we just start running through this wizard. So you would hit next. Accept and continue, but if you want, you can view the license agreement, and once you're comfortable with all that, you have no choice but to accept it if you want to get this installed. And you will need the license number information and product number, which you should have provided in the email when you had the renewal. Now you can choose the express installation or the custom, which allows you to do a lot more. Since it's a upgrade, you can stick with the express. Otherwise, if it's a brand new install, you can go into custom and change how you want this to be installed, but it would prompt you as well anyway. In this case, it's an upgrade and we probably don't want to have any shortcuts added. It's up to you. You can always delete the shortcuts afterwards and then hit install. At this point, it's going to run for some period of time and install all the necessary files to upgrade the software. So we'll skip ahead on this part and continue from there. So for me, only a short 2 minutes later, it says the installation is complete and we can now go into opening QuickBooks. It's going to want you to activate it, so we'll go ahead and click Begin Activation, and it contacts the server. You'd have to be online on the internet for this to work. And this is a little bit new this time because they're asking you to sign in so you have one account for everything. So if you're already signed up using a phone number, email, or user ID, you could enter that in and then sign in. So here they want to email a code to you to make sure that it's you. It does take a little bit, but then we're able to check the email and get the code that we can then copy and paste into here. I got my code, I copy and paste it in there, and I'll hit continue. And here they want to have your phone number just to try and help keep your account safe. So the more information you provide, the more there is for anyone to verify. Make sure you choose the correct country code, and if you're able to verify with a text message, then that's an extra layer of security to protect your account. So you'd want to make sure that you enter a phone number that can accept text messages. Hit continue, and we should now get a text message with a code that we can enter in here. For some reason, I'm having trouble with this, as this is a new setup that they never did this in previous versions of QuickBooks, and I'm having trouble typing in the code, and I don't see any option here to refresh the screen. We'll have to skip this for now, since I really can't get anywhere, and then we're able to set up a password to have on your account. As soon as you click in to type in the password, it does tell you to use 8 or more characters and that you should use upper and lowercase, adding in a number and a symbol ideally. If you have something that it likes, then it'll give you all green for everything to go, and then simply retype the password in the confirm password field, and then you can continue. It'll verify your information that you should already know. You can print that if you want to, otherwise it should all be something that you already have. So there really isn't much need to print this at all. So we'll just close it, yes, and then you got the usual welcome screen telling you information if you need help, how to use it. We'll just hit OK, and then we can go to open our existing file. And of course, it's giving us an issue right off the bat here that there's problems opening the program. So this unfortunately wasn't a very smooth upgrade. So we're going to have to see what went wrong with this, and then we'll be able to open the file and see if it's going to want to make us upgrade it. I just simply tried again and I'm able to get prompted to log in. And now that I was able to log in, it's first asking us to back up your data because it's going to want to upgrade your company file. So we'll hit OK and you can choose to do a local backup and tell it where you want to save this. It'll remember your other settings from before, which you can probably change as well. And a complete verification is recommended, which is why it says that in brackets. So it's a good idea, especially because we're doing a full upgrade, not just a regular day-to-day backup. It's confirming that the hard drive that you're saving it to is the same as the drive that the data is on. It's not a good idea to do that, but if you're storing it there and then backing up everything to an external afterwards, then that's okay, as long as in the end you're going to have a copy of your data in two different places in case the one drive dies. So I'm going to say use this location anyway. Now that it's backed up, it wants to upgrade the company file, so yes, we want to do this. And this process will take a lot longer because it has to upgrade the database, so depending on the size of your database and the speed of your computer, that can vary how long it's going to take. Of course, my database is not that big, and I have a pretty super fast computer, and it's already done by the time I finish saying this. One of the things you're going to want to do once it opens up here is go under Help and About. You should be able to see that you're on the current version, and it'll verify your license information below as well. Also, it's a good idea to run some reports. So you can go in and do some standard reports, such as balance sheet standard, and you can ask your accountant as well which ones are the best reports that you can run to verify. And you should run the report before you do the upgrade and then again afterwards, just to make sure that everything is great. And then you can also go in to look at your invoices and see from the last things that you entered and make sure that that information is still there. And that's it for this tutorial. I hope you found it helpful, and if you did, please do give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.